Let's stay with matters health and go to Kabale District, where medics have expressed worry at what they see is the increasing number of COVID cases there. It's understood that at Kabale Regional Referral Hospital, the director, Dr. Sophie Namasopo, has spoken of 45 patients currently admitted, with 3 in critical condition.
Dr. Namasopo made the remarks during the swearing-in of the new management board for Kabale Regional Referral Hospital. She said that they continue to grapple with shortage of relevant medication for COVID-19, which has limited the service delivery at the hospital.
With a high number of COVID-19 cases, currently we have 45 patients in admission and still grappling with shortage of medicines and supplies especially for the patients with COVID. And for the oxygen plant, there's a high consumption of electricity, and yet with a high number of patients, it does not actually meet the demand of the patient.
The swearing-in ceremony was presided over by the Kabale Grade 1 Magistrate Isaac Rukundo, and the new board was inaugurated by the State Minister for General Duties, Hanifa Banginana Kawoya. According to Dr. Namasopo, if the hospital had better drug supply, they would be in position to serve all patients as expected. Most locals in Kabale District have foregone the standard operating procedures, which have also increased the spread of the pandemic.
One thing I would like to appeal to the public is to ensure that we observe the SOPs. Because most times when I move around town, most of us do not have masks. And we are all in crowded places. So if we are to curb this COVID, especially in Kabale, that the numbers are rising, it's important that we observe the source.
The State Minister for General Duties, Hanifa Kawoya, warned residents of Kabale against being reckless towards the pandemic, which could lead the nation into the third wave.
The waves, the COVID-19 waves, so far we had the first one. We saw the effects of these waves. We went into a second one. The second one also came with its worst waves. Now we are anticipating a third one. The unfortunate part of it is that the Kabale region has been listed as one of the regions that we are getting worried that the third wave will find its entry. Now, we are calling upon the communities and we are calling upon the board, because this board is a combination of the pro community. It has all the stakeholders, from all representatives, from all the district representatives that make the Kabale region. Now, this is the only way that it was the best that we are here to echo, and strongly to echo, that the communities must be mobilized to ensure they adhere to the SOPs and the presidential directive.
She said that since Kabale has already been highlighted as a hotspot by authorities, more efforts should be directed to the district. After his swearing in, the new board chairperson for the hospital, Dr. Ananias Muhunde, pledged to advocate for quality services at the hospital.
Miss an opportunity to make wealth out of someone's ill health. To this, advocacy for ethics is far cry. On the other hand, the board is charged with the responsibility to appreciate the prevailing situation. It goes without saying, therefore, that quality of care is not solely dependent on the quality of the provider, but on his motivation and also on the quality of the tools provided.
The new board takes over from the old board, which was chaired by Dr. Francis Mwesjerunumi, whose tenure expired in December 2020. Story by Job Namanya for the news.